Morning, guys. It's October 1st. It's the start of the hunting season for moose, the big game draw in Saskatchewan here. And I got fortunate enough to get drawn for that and mule deer. So I'm headed out this morning to take a look around. I really don't want to shoot one. It's pretty mild right now. It's supposed to be up to, I think, 20 degrees today, which is too much or too hot for, you know, one guy to deal with a moose. So I will look around, you know, if it's a monster, then I guess I would be forced to shoot it, but I'm gonna go out and see what happens, see what transpires today. So, all right, let's standing right in behind there. He's just moving off. It's his lucky day because I'm not going to shoot him. He'd be tasty. He might be in a couple days. Today's supposed to go up to 21 degrees and I don't plan on killing a little fellow like that on a day like today. So, hey guys, next morning after that bull, a cow and a calf there. Nice to see. It's been pretty quiet. That's the land I could hunt on, but I'm not shooting either one of those. Very scenic though. Morning. That's a young bull. He's safe. He's on posted land. I'm hearing another moose. That's also on posted land that I can't hunt. See that black dot out there? That's a bull out there. Pretty decent one, but he's standing right in the middle of the swamp. So watch him a bit and see which direction he's gonna go, but this is land I can shoot on. But like, he is right in the middle of the water. So I'll have to see what he does. All right. Well, that's a no show. He wouldn't answer, and I walked till I got to the water's edge. And that's as far as I'm willing to go in for one guy to deal with a moose. And that crap is terrible. But see, this stuff I'm going through here right now is way taller than I thought, you know. Because this used to be a farm field. I shot a deer in here one time. Hey guys, happened really fast here. I was just coming back to help a friend here. And this over where he shot his moose, and I saw a black spot going across the field. I had to run like a son of a bitch to get down there to get a shot. And I went to the other field first and looked, and then by the time I came over to the other one, he was almost into the bush, and he's just ahead of me here now. He might still be kicking. I was just going to put another shot to him, and he bedded down. Right in here. Looking at me, you can see him there. A tree or something there. You know, guys, I found them. Dropped them. I actually kind of just beelined in here and walked right up on them, so I got lucky that way. But I gotta get the dinners knocked out. I started on that already before I remembered what I was doing, and I gotta flag a trail back up to the edge of the bush. Hopefully it's easy. So okay, I gotta get this done.
Center of the screen. He's laying out there now. Right there in the middle. But I've got my shot blocked by the rail on the fence here, so I've got to wait him out.
Well, he got up quick and turned around, and I didn't have time to turn my video on. I was texting somebody, obviously, doing something stupid, but I nailed him. He ran up the tree there and only got about 15 feet up, and that was it. So, we'll check him out, I guess. Give him a bit here to expire. Where's the bear?
There. He's right there.
So you had to go get a crew to help me. Yeah, and I left the pail here. I didn't even know. So
There he is, just a ferret middling bear. I'll get you to hold it again here. You got the light to hold him up. I'll get it. Just in here. So.
Hey, I see. He pooped when he died.
He thinks that's, yeah, that happens, yeah. Oh, he's a fat little fart. All right, now we gotta.
If he's fat, then he has lots of meat.
Get him over
and
on the trailer, eh? Well, there'll be some meat there, yeah.
Nice fat bear. It's a female. I thought it was going to be a young boar. So we're going to get the meat off it here. I'm not going to do anything with the hide, I don't think, but I'll pull it off and freeze it and
decide later once I get around to dealing with wolves and whatnot what I'm going to do with it. But anyhow, we're going to take some of this meat, like the behinds and the back straps, and get that cut up, put away. But oh, sorry. Anyways, I just sort of
show you that what I'm doing. Experiment, see what happens.
Intense heat coming off of that now.
I think some of these big logs here are not going to burn up on this first burn, but at least we get the bulk of it down and we'll push in another pile and burn it again. Later this year, or maybe next year, or whatever. I'm trying to burn this pile for 3 years now, and every time that I get a giant dump of snow, or I miss the day that I could have been out here, so we got it rolling now. So. Yeah, hopefully it spreads these other ends. Well, that's pretty much it. That's about 3 hours it took to burn that pile down. So I still got all this garden stuff here that's gonna smolder away for a while, but for the most part, she's gone. There's some big stuff here in the middle that never burned, so I'll have to go on another pile and give her again. And he's coming.